some high school, if you, Dan or Bruce, if you teach high school students or anybody else that might, we have a high school chamber brass competition at the School of the Arts, which Consumer is the first prize of $1,250. And the second prize is $750, the third prize is $500, which is the Rainey's third prize, used to teach at our school for 24 years. So we're really thrilled about that Consumer development or involvement with that. And it is for high school students only. 3 to 5 but I just kind of want to put that out there because we are really thrilled. We think we should be in the country that's doing a high school chamber brass competition dedicated for that group of students. So I know a lot of you are probably educators. Who are the educators to be in the audience? Music educators? A few. And we got some others. And performance majors? Okay. Do you have recording? I don't know what your majors are here. Composition? Recording?
We have lots of non-majors.
Wonderful. Wonderful. So people majoring in other things plus trumpet. Ah, those are always often the best practicers. Okay. So I'm not going to play for you because I want you to play for me. And obviously I'll play a little bit then. So I normally open up my master classes with a little unaccompanied piece, but we've got a lot of stuff that we're doing. And I just played on last night a really big concert. I don't know if you were able to catch that. Each university usually has a life of its own with all kinds of stuff going on. So who's up first?
This is Brian Biggs.
Excellent. Hi, Brian. How are you? Good morning. And good afternoon almost.
Oh, yes. I'm going to be playing the first movement of the Latham Suite.
Excellent. First movement. What year are you in school?
I'm a senior this year.
Oh, wow. Fantastic. Okay, so before you begin, if you want to play with notes, please do.
Oh,
and I would just ask you to turn around because you're going to warm up.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
since I wasn't even acknowledging that they were there. I was unaware. Thank you very much. Okay, so tell me if you've already performed this or you're going to perform it.
I will be performing this next semester.
Next semester is the time for a recital?
Right.
Aha, fantastic. What else have you got planned?
This one, an arrangement of vocalese.
Beautiful.
A couple of baroque big trumpet pieces.
Very, very nice. Wonderful. Anytime we can get other colors rather than just be flat trumpet, it really helps the audience. And of course, as a trumpet player, you have to be fluent in so many trumpets. People ask me how many trumpets I have, and I say, I can only play one at once. So, you know, you need about 8 different if you're going to make a career as a classical player and teacher. But really, you need one at a time. Okay, so a couple things I noticed. You actually really know the piano score quite well in terms of coming in and counting and all that stuff. And it's not super, super easy to do that with this piece because it's, you know, a little quirky.
Right.
So good work on that. The thing I noticed immediately is this piece, you know, linear or intervallic, primarily, throughout?
I'd say intervallic.
Right, lots of intervals. Fancy name for lots of intervals, right? So when we play intervallically, we must still remember that our wind is very stupid. And it goes out straight. I call it, my brother's a farmer, and I call it stupid cow air. Because if anybody knows anything about cows, they're like, and they just keep going forward until you kind of make yourself really vague and go, you know, stop. So our wind needs to go forward nonstop all the time. And when you see and produce these sounds, you are kind of stopping the air. So, does that sound somewhat similar to you? Okay, I'm trying to like be you for a second. So, what I'm hearing is that when the wind stops, then the lips have to take over and do so much more work. So, if we can go, right, that's fine. It's making the translation into the trumpet. So it sounds like you've done some wind patterns before. Yeah, we're gonna do it right now. So grab the back of your hand and do that. Yeah. Okay, that's all good. Making the transition over to the mouthpiece. I think I'm similar pitch. I don't have perfect pitch, just relative. Da 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 da. Okay, let the, okay, the buzz is happening, now we need the tongue to be a little more in the game. Yeah. Okay, better. So the tongue is blue, 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 right?
Mm-hmm.
So do this. That's wind. Thank you, that's Tom. So really clarify the difference. Say totally tubular.
Totally tubular.
That's Tom. Totally tubular.
Totally tubular.
Okay. That's all Tom. When you get on here and you feel more resistance, you're backing off on the Tom because you're like, so you have to really be, go ahead and put that tongue in the mix. Okay? Yeah, don't be afraid to let the tongue do that. Not hoo-hoo-hoo. Right, even on there. One more time. Because this is where the, I think this is where it kind of shuts down a little bit on you. So let's get it right here first before we go to the trumpet. That's better. Put it on there. You'll feel more resistance. Again, put in what you want. Don't react to what you feel. Okay, so I think we're a step high. No, we're not. Okay, so the air is going, it's doing that again. Mr. Chickwich used to call that the air is blocky. So you've got to find a place on the horn that you can blow into. So I'd like you to kind of do that with your hand, and I'd like you to lean into it with your foot. So where you're going and finding the middle of the note. There it is. You hear the sound get. Okay?
Yeah.
So when you play, every single note needs to be put in all the way into that resistance. Try that on G.
These are little pedagogical things. They're good for any age. I'll just give you one. All right.
Oh, well, you're going to
I'm going to hang on the back here. Yeah. But thank you.
So, I figured there'd be something to help your
shadow. Over your right shoulder.
Once you get it, if you go back to the last two pages of it, we'll look at that in a bit. It's just some thinking things. The last two pages is like a little survey. What do you do to warm up? And it asks lots of questions specifically designed to make you think. First page, we'll get to in a little bit, but if you turn the last two pages, just kind of look through that a little bit. Hello! Who are you?
Michael.
And what year are you in?
I'm a grad student.
Oh, wow, fantastic. I didn't even know you had a grad program.
Yes.
Oh, wonderful. Live and learn. Well, I'm not trying to steal your grad students. Oh, good. So first year, second year?
I've actually been here since 2011. I'm going slowly through it.
Oh, wow. Congratulations. That's a lot of you. Should we go, like, over here?
Oh, that's fine.
Okay. And we have another pianist. Thank you very much. You have to be very nice to our piano colleagues. They will support us only if we're nice to them. Care and feeding of a pianist. That and composers. If you know any composers, be really nice to them and befriend them, and then they'll start writing your music. And it's really wonderful. We need these collaborations. So, do you want to play a couple notes?
Yes.
So in the orchestra, in the strings and continuo, what is normally happening note length-wise to the eighth notes that are underneath you? Are they... or are they...
I think they'd be more marked.
Right, absolutely, a little bit shorter. So you can play these long. You would probably listen to a lot of people, hopefully, mm-hmm. play this tune. But we need more of a lift in the sound to have the joyful quality of the sparkliness of the piccolo come out. Mm-hmm. Okay? So I do have a piccolo, unfortunately, it's not a grand summer piccolo. And I wasn't anticipating playing it this morning. But you can see I need a new one, so I should approach Consumer. Because the bell is all crunchy. So God knows what this is going to sound like. And we'll find out really soon.
It will sound cold.
Let's see. I'm going to push it out really far. So. I could use a lot more phrasing. Have you ever heard a Baroque orchestra play? That's really cool.
Live. Not live.
It's pretty cool to see them live. So make a pilgrimage. Like if somebody's playing 2 hours from here, it's worth going. So you've heard them, a Baroque orchestra play on recording?
Yes.
Okay. They usually don't have a conductor, and they do it all, like the big string quartet, they do it all by moving and phrasing a ton. So, beep. So this pickup is a pickup to this starting phrase. Bee, yum, bum, bing, bum, bing. So I'd like you to take the phrasing to enable you to get more musical and to create a little lift in the sound. And no note is a throwaway. That low C printed, you're not allowed to throw it away. It has to sound beautiful. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Can you try that? Bee, ba, ba, bee, oh, yeah. And just finger through it. Bee, ba, ba, bee. da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da Ready, go.
We are the Concelmer dealer in Greenville and in South Carolina that's supporting Ms. Haxton's visit here. Yay. And we have brought accessories, instruments, freebies, giveaways, product literature, hats, and so on.
Oh, cool.
And also we've brought a selection of accessories and music. If you're not prepared with cash, check, or credit card today, that's fine. You can call us. We deliver to the university 6 days a week, and we give you, basically our ministry is to sell to you at our cost. We sell to the Bob Jones community and related churches like Mount Calvary, Hampton Park, et cetera, Faith, at our cost. So we hope that you will consider using our services and come see us. If you can't, we're only 8 minutes from here, but if you can't come see us, if you don't have a car, give us a call. We'll have business cards over there. This is Derek Bowen. He's the district manager for ConSelmer, and he's the one actually responsible for all this, so he's the one who should get the applause.
So the name of your shop is Musical Innovation.
Yes, ma'am.
And do you deliver onto campus?
6 days a week.
See, they deliver.
At no charge.
That's like, there you
That's
go.
That's even better than trying to make a left turn out of campus.
That is incredible. That's incredible.
Thank you, Tracy.
Thanks for supporting
Thank you,
too. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, people just ready to go.
Yes, ma'am.
Great.
This is an unaccompanied etude.
Okay.
So
the best kind of etude.
We get the raw meat.
That's wonderful.
Okay, here we go. So this is the Brandt etude number 7.
Mm, very nice. And if you want to play a couple notes, I just ask that you turn around, and then we'll know when you're ready to go. Excellent. Teachers in the country, I mean, the coasts, everybody's, there's fantastic teachers everywhere. But people often go to Chicago to get the pedagogy of how the sound from the Chicago Symphony, and there's a very rich school of brass playing there. So I hear a lot of this already happening here, which is fantastic. But, you know, sing and buzz and play, and we don't just talk about it, we do it. So you sing it, you buzz it, you play it, and a lot of reliance on the wind, not the chops. So that comes really out of that school, and I just want to kind of tribute that school. That's my training and where I'm from in terms of my approach at this point. So, okay, Grant's ready and raring to go. So The reason is so that you can see how people perform and not just hear them, right? And at the end of every piece of anything, people hold for, I call it the 2-second rule. Just don't blink, don't move, don't pass go, don't collect $200, just right there. Don't move at all, okay? And decide what volume you'd like. Okay? So how about if we do the last statement of the theme there? There's even more reason to look for phrasing. People think, oh, I'm playing an Etude 9 in my technical zone. This is a chance, and it really is an opportunity to look for phrasing to aid in your technique. Okay? So, you're musical, I can hear that already. Again, let's just, I've never had a student, I think ever, when I ask them to be more musical, I've never had somebody be too musical. I actually have never experienced that. I would love to experience that here today. I lay down the gauntlet of talent.
We have to roll it back up.
Okay. Because it gives me my first thing I ask for, With resonance comes the ability to play soft, middle, and loud with great tone. And I'm noticing that you're struggling a little bit with endurance to get through it. And part of that is because, again, we're doing little bullets there. So, it has to be really, there is no such thing as a short mainstream. It just doesn't exist. When I play, let's see. I'm going. It's really long. It doesn't do that at all. It doesn't protect your chops enough. Okay? So do the wind. Yeah? When you get to the little notes, you can see it back here. It just stops the air. This is kind of, people, I'm going to say something which isn't often spoken out loud, but you can actually stop the air with the tongue a little bit, rather than back here. Say tut, tut, tut.
Tut, tut, tut.
That's better. So you can blow long and just stop the air that way. Does that make any sense?
Yes.
You're really not stopping it, is my point. It's falling forward musically. Can we try the opening that way? It's going to go like this. Do that with your... Good, do it again. Good, do it really low. Excellent. Two, three. Right there, it changed. And you can hear the sound change. So, again, put that wind through the instrument and go play into the resistance and really be very long. Yes. Big yes. Okay? Because that protects your face. When you want it to be short, you simply conceive it short. Da 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 dee. Sing that long and short. Da da da.
Da da da.
Long first. Da da da.
Da da da.
Da da da.
Da da da.
What changes?
It's
hard.
It's a trick question.
It's hard to determine that, right? The production, in other words, how you sing, does not change. Same thing on the trumpet. We never change production. Stupid cow air all the time. So when it goes to a short note, you're tending to change production. Can't do it. Unless, well, you can do it, but it doesn't afford you the sound and the endurance that you would like. Okay, so still very forward with the wind all the time. Okay? See if we can do that in a spot that is a little bit more... I think we're going to run out of time. Maybe one more minute with him. Let's go into this. Yeah, especially here. Do that. Doesn't have to be pitches, just like I did. Excellent. One more time. Nice job. Put it on the trumpet. Two, three, and. Let's do it again. So it's gonna be literally musically that's what happens. It doesn't go. So leading to the beat two. Duck D. So the wind is going forward. Okay? Two, three, and. Follows our command. basically. But I love the sound that you're getting, and I know that you're getting more juice for your face so that you can have more resonance without working. Yeah, and it helps you expand your dynamic palette of color. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Because you're a beautiful player, and you have a lot going on.
Thank you very much.
Very
much.
Hop up. And any questions at all, fire away. Oh, look at the sheets while he's getting ready. So the last two pages are the ones that ask all kinds of questions about you. Oh, I'm going to steal one back. Can I steal yours for a second? So warm-up practice routine. And just ask me lots of questions just to get you thinking. Because every day you should be doing some stretching and breathing. Why is breathing good? Because we have to have wind. But why else? Oxygen goes to your brain. It helps you think better. Okay? So brain power is what drives the trumpet. And we need to be able to have lots of brain power, and that's what oxygen gives you. And then I asked you a lot of questions that seem like they're the same question over and over, but they're a little bit different based on at what point in your warm-up you do these things. So you get to see a teacher one-on-one probably an hour a week. That's the way it is in most schools of music. What are you going to do for the rest of your time? You have to be the world's most smart practicer. So your warm-up every day is not a chance only to get, it's not your only a chance to get your chops and your, you know, musculature going. It's a chance to get your brain in gear. And the first page is a page of mouthpiece tunes. And a lot of people have mouthpiece things they do. I really recommend tunes, because it gets both sides of the brains engaged when you do a study. They who did it, but when you sing, you can see both sides of the brain lighting up. And sometimes if you just go, you know, there's nothing lighting up but one side of the brain. So we want to be musicians first, always. Trumpet players second. Okay.
Hi.
Hi.
Ben.
That's and what year are you, Ben?
Junior.
Okay, fantastic. And what are you going to play?
I'm going to play a piece of the Neruda first movement.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, just give yourself maybe four bars in between.
Sure.
Or longer if you'd like. Okay, so he's got a little Neruda and the same drill if you want to turn around and warm up.
Thank you.
really is. You play it in the very end. And so we have a trill, and however you do it, and then just hold 2 seconds. So it really is a performance, okay? That's it, it's much better. And in the course of a piece, are you playing this coming up on a jury or a recital or?
No, just for leisure.
Okay, so, in the course of the piece, also, you want to be aware of how fast you take your horn down, because it actually affects the production of the sound at the very end, and also how we hear it. Okay? So, where was the end of the first part? I'm going to have to scroll here. So, yes. Make it obvious for us. We're like plasma people. We're like, you know, we don't know anything until you kind of fill us up when we go to a concert. So the communication becomes two-way when you make it so clear and we're like, oh, wow, I really like that. Then there's a two-way communication. If you're like kind of halfway clear, we're like, what? And then you don't get anything back from the audience. So really a lot of clarity and deliberateness. Here, I'll give you a rum, bum, 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 bum. Sense of understanding the music nice sense of phrasing. You just have to do more of it. very, very nice foundations to, and it's a joy. It's a joy to be here and be able to work with you all. So thank you for your time.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.